going to be a big issue. But, Jen, we've got to wait still for the system to develop. It is in its infancy stage, really, still.
Yeah. Yeah. I know it feels windy now, but it's going to get a lot windier actually once that low pressure really gets going. I want to talk more about planning for the wind, the flooding, and the snow here in Chicago. Let's bring in Rich Guidis right now. He's the executive director of the City of Chicago Office of Emergency Management and Communications. Rich, thanks for joining us. Let's talk about the plan for the snow and how that has changed since the forecast has changed.
Well, a lot of things have changed.
Quite yet. Gorgeous picture right there. It was also a very warm day yesterday. Let's kind of recap what your Monday looked like here in Central Park. It was 62 degrees. Hopefully you took your lunch outside. 60 degrees for Philly and D.C. This is a warm spring day, especially for the month of February, right? Above average temperatures all over the I-95 corridor. Now the clouds and the rain have arrived or are going to arrive shortly, and temperatures are still above average, but not quite cold enough for snow in many locations. You have to go well to the north, and you have to gain elevation before you hit some of that wintry mix or snow. We got moisture flowing northbound, and when you get these inside runners, these low pressures that track over the interior sections of the northeast, we're able to bring in more of that mild Atlantic air. So that's going to keep us in the form of rain for the big cities on the 95 corridor. However, there is cold air that does come rushing in behind it. But by the time the cold air reaches us along the coast, the moisture is moving out. So the timing kind of misses us here in terms of snowfall. Now, there will be some snow already. The National Weather Service has issued winter storm watches for portions of Maine, New Hampshire, Vermont, all the way back into New York State. So there is a potential that some areas could see 6 inches or more of accumulation. In fact, we bring out the map and we show you the light purple, anywhere from 5 to 8, some places getting up to a foot of snow in the Adirondacks. Great news for ski resorts. And even look at New Hampshire and parts of Maine. We could see a foot to a foot and a half of accumulation. But here, too, the winds will be picking up just like in the Midwest. And eventually the cold air does come in, especially as we head toward the end of this week, Steph.
All right. So, Charlotte, I was looking. You have some visibility issues, some delays. They were like 30 to 45 minutes. You're going to have the clouds. You're going to have the rain today. It's going to linger, especially into Florida. This is where we have that chance for flooding. I shouldn't say flooding, for some of the heavier rain. Charleston up towards Myrtle Beach, even the OBX, Outer Banks. But you see this nice sharp line here. Northwest of this, you've got that sunshine. It is going to be nice and bright and brilliant. Clouds hanging on, though, especially into places like southern Georgia. Look at Florida, getting that rain streaming in. But dare I say it's going to snow in the south? Well, you might get some exciting little novelty flakes. Possibility tomorrow for thunderstorms as this whole system moves east. Watch as we go through the overnight hours, all right? This is a Wednesday afternoon, I should say. And then as we head into Wednesday evening, maybe around Nashville and Tennessee, North Georgia, you might see just a few flakes. They're all just going to be in good fun. Higher elevations, of course, you'll have a better chance of picking up some of that snow. Otherwise, it's Florida that is going to have the bulk of the rain here through tomorrow for us in the south. And it's going to be light otherwise into Georgia and the Carolinas. Kelly.
And watch out for flooding with some of that heavy rain. Flash floods killed 92 people in the U.S. in 2019. And just 7 weeks into 2020, we've had 9 deaths already. New this morning, a family in Arizona will never forget their terrifying ride that could have easily made them just another statistic.